millions of people who rely on the river for their livelihoods. As our motto says, the Mekong River Commission does its best for meeting the needs, keeping the balance. To do this, we must know what everyone's needs are, and we must understand what measures we can take to keep the balance. As always, the MRC appreciates your concerns and your aspirations for the sustainable development and use of this unique river's ecosystem. We cannot do this without your constructive inputs and comments. Learning from the two previous prior consultations processes at Saibari and Dong Sahab, we have increased the transparency and effort put into stakeholder engagement both at the regional and national levels. This forum is just one of those initiatives. During the course of the day, you will hear of other initiatives we have taken to open up the results of the technical review process to a wider audience, and I would like to invite you to study the huge volume of information on the Pathland project. The review process and the prior consultation process on our website. As this is the last forum before the end of the official 6 months prior consultation process, I am delighted to see high interest from such a broad range of stakeholders as well as the variety of groups represented. As we participate in the forum today, listen to what we achieved from the last forum in Luang Prabang. Pay attention to the specialists presenting the preliminary technical review of the Pathland Hydropower project. And after that, discuss, share your voices, opinions, and recommendations on the project. Today, you also hear what our plans are for completing the 6 months prior consultation process and what we hope to do after the official prior consultation process ended in order to maintain open and transparent engagement in the ongoing development of the project. Dear participants, our fruitful discussions in the first forum in Luang Prabang provided valuable comments and inputs. We registered about 150 comments, inputs, and suggestions. We have taken care to build this into the technical review process so far. My hope is that this forum will build on that first event and that this forum, just like the first one, will be positively received. I would like to add something that we learned from public meetings of the Mississippi River Commission back in September and lately in April this year. If any one of you would like to have your questions, inquiries, or comments to be answered, please communicate that, those wishes to our secretariat. We cannot promise you to answer all of them in writing. However, we'll try to do our best. The reason is that we have limited resources and time. During the first forum, we live streamed the main part of the meeting, and we are live streaming some parts on Facebook today. So you have every reason to put your best foot forward and to engage in lively and positive discussion. We'll take the outcomes of today's forum forward into the final version of the technical review report and discussions in the special sessions of the MRC Joint Committee, which will conclude the official 6 months prior consultation period. We value your contributions. We are committed to supporting the Mekong countries in meeting of national development while keeping the balance and recognizing the concerns of all who depend on this river system. Towards these aims, identifying all reasonable measures to avoid, minimize, mitigate potential transboundary impacts lies at the heart of the prior consultation process. Your inputs are vital to ensuring that the process does indeed identify potential impacts and corresponding possible measures. Lastly, I would like to thank the government of Lao PDR for co-hosting the second regional stakeholder forum. My special appreciation and sincere thanks to Your Excellency, the Vice President of Natural Resources and Environment, Madame Monmani, for your presence today. I hope that the views and opinions, as well as the recommendations from participants, will be well received by all of us here and by the Lao government. My thanks and appreciations also go to the MRC Secretariat staff for their hard work and devotion in getting all materials prepared and distributed in a timely and organized manner. I look forward to fruitful discussion from all of you. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Fan. Yes, he's welcomed and values all comments and input from the participants of these stakeholder forums today, in order that the Secretariat will be able to maintain to meet with meeting the need from Vice Ministers of Natural Resource and Environment of Lao to deliver opening remarks. Madame Monmani.
It's highly vulnerable to climate change impacts. Our country is being faced to more frequent and severe natural disasters. Studies reveal that Laos faces the highest 100-year probable maximum loss relative to GDP, with 100-year losses as high as 11.7 of national GDP, and natural disaster damage costs estimated at between 2.8 and 3.7% of national GDP. The LPR has faced great emphasizes on increasing green and sustainable economic growth, being more resilient to the risk of natural disasters and climate change, and readiness to cope with their scale impacts. Despite tremendous challenges, the LPR reiterates its strong commitment to the effective realization of the 1995 legal agreement and the fight against the global warming. This aim is clearly stipulated in our 2030 vision, the 2025 strategy, the objectives of our 8th National Social Economic Union Plan, our National Identity Plan, and our nationally intended contribution on the climate change. By the year 2020, the five components of the Mekong River Basin will be managed with the IWRM approach. 70% of the country's land will have forest cover. 90% of the large rural households will have electricity. Hydropower exports will expand to enable neighboring countries to grow in a more sustainable way with clean and renewable energy. As part of this utmost endeavor, Laos will continue to contribute. 48% of the flow of a mighty Mekong River and the richness of its biological diversity resources. Excellencies, distinguished delegates, 2007, we welcome and participate in the first regional stakeholder forum in Luang Prabang to hear and discuss on the details of the proposed Back Bay project. At each time, project staff presented the result of many years of comprehensive studies that led to the initial design and operating rules of the project. We remain open to your concerns, comments, questions, and suggestions. We welcome the new accommodation that will emerge from this stakeholder forum and from the technical review of the detailed design and implementation. As was the case with the Sayaburi and Don Sahong consultation, we will remain open to your input even after conclusion of the required 6-month review period. We call this post-consultation. It means we will listen to your concerns without any time limit or deadline. If there is merit, we will act on it. Some of you may recall that as part of our ongoing commitment to transparency around hydropower development on the Mekong River, we organized field trips to Sayaburi and Don Sahong. At Sayaburi, we made it possible for stakeholders to see for themselves the significant modification the Lavria and Liverpool are making to ensure fish migration, sediment flushing, and freedom of navigation. There is measure taken in response to the MRC final consultation process required substantial additional investment, which we understood in the spirit of the Mekong cooperation and best practices. The LAVIA remains committed to this baseline approach in connection with the proposed Back Bay hydrocarbon. Should you wish to monitor the progress at Back Bay, the Lao government stands ready to facilitate your visit. We assure that LAVIA takes stakeholder participation seriously and remains committed to undergoing the consultation process for all mainstream hydrocarbon projects. We reiterate our determination to balance stakeholders and member countries' concern with national development and regional energy needs. I would like to take this opportunity to express our sense of appreciation to all member countries for their continued support to our country's sustainable development program, and to our great partners for their relentless assistance to our MRC activities. We also recognize international organizations and civil society for their valuable comments. Finally, I extend my heartfelt appreciation to the Mekong River Commission Secretariat under the guidance and the guidance of the fund for the excellent arrangement of this stakeholder fund. May I take this opportunity to declare our meeting open. I wish all of you a productive forum with fruitful outcome.
Thank you, Excellencies, Madame Mamoni, for a fruitful opening remarks. So, may I invite Excellencies, Mr. Ettore and Dr. Tham Chuan Phan to sit at this reserved table. So we will prepare the stage. It's all 1 hour where all stakeholders and participants can decide whether which small group discussions, which divided into 4 groups. The first group is hydrology and sediment. Second group, environment and fisheries. Then third group, dam safety and navigation. And the fourth group, social economy. So in these 60 minutes, the participants will come to the last one, conclusion and next step. So, we've shown to you at the first stakeholder forum, and you see over there, we are at the second regional stakeholder forum, where the report of the review will be shared, and we welcome your comments and your suggestions. Then we will continue to end the process. Dr. Hanna will talk more about this process during the next sections. And as usual, in all of the forums or the meeting, we should have the ground rules. So there are.
So in, you know, we walk the talk. We have put this stakeholder engagement in our basic improvement strategy, very important, not just to focus on the government system and consultation with our government counterparts, but as well as reaching out to all of you, private sector, research institutes, NGOs. So this is well established in our strategy for the next 5 years. And as well as in our strategic plan, we have what is called now the regional stakeholder platform. And this forum is one of the mechanisms to consult with all of you in all our work. And we have conceptualized this process in a very simple diagram. I showed this one some time ago as well in the first forum. But basically, if you look at the bottom part, the red part, those are all of the MRC work. So we do strategies, we have procedures, we have guidelines, we do monitoring, we do cooperation, we do studies. So all of that have a mechanism, different mechanism of consultation with stakeholders, right? So and the mechanism within the rectangular part. And then if you look at the processes, we identify about three processes. First, we want to communicate. Second, to consult. So this is one of the consultation. And thirdly, to collaborate, if possible. Right. And we have various tools to do that. And the ultimate objective is basically, this is in our strategic plan, effective dialogue and cooperation between member countries and broader stakeholders and partners. So this is a 5-year outcome of our strategic plan, one of the main outcomes. If you look back at the Sayaburi consultation and the Donsholm consultation, we found that it was very first time. And there were a number of things that we did, and a number of things that we did not do. So learning from that, we have put in place various mechanisms to improve for this part bank process. For example, in the Sayaburi consultation, if you remember back to 2009, there was no public forum. And then in Donsholm, it was organized, one was very late. So part of the part bank improvement is that we want to share with you very early the information, and that one we did in the long command. So what is the objective of all this? And I think this is very important to always state, because we don't want any misunderstanding, or we want you to appreciate. Okay. First of all, I think the first objective is to share information. Just imagine that if you don't have this forum, where would you get information about a project of a country that is implemented on an international river? You may get misinformation, you may get rumors, right? So this is a forum where you get the correct information submitted officially by a government. And the second role is to clarify what all of this is. So we think, is a process that is legitimate, that provides room to hear your voice, to share information, to discuss, and to take those views into account. And thirdly, to get information and opinions and viewpoint from you, and to document that very clearly, as we have done here and on our website, and to feed those comments back into the process in order to be considered by our governance body, first the Joint Committee, and then eventually up to the higher level. Lastly, I think it's important to also say that because we invite everybody to participate in this process. It's important to know that this is not about seeking your endorsement, or this is not about if you participate or not participate, that you reject the process or reject the project. So it's really about information sharing, consultation, and collaboration. So we will not, you know, say that you're here and you endorse this process. Whatever. What is the scope of engagement? So we, because this is an international river, we try to focus our discussions and assessment on the transboundary aspects of all of this. So we recognize that the project is in Laos and it has positive and potentially adverse consequences for Lao PDR, but that is a national, mostly national issue. And that is taken care of within the national system. But of course, in our technical report, we also suggest best practices and things like that. But the primary focus is on the transboundary impacts, or the possible transboundary impacts, positive and negative, as well as to recommend measures to avoid, minimize, mitigate. And last but not least, recommend measures for cooperation, benefits, optimize. So, what happened at the last meeting? I think, can I ask how many of you were at the last meeting? Okay, so about half. So, the rest have heard about it. So, what happened was, it was in February, it was just a couple of months after the official submission, and that was when we shared all of the project documents on our website. We clearly communicate what the process was about. We re-emphasize the importance of all of this engagement, and we sought your preliminary views, which were documented on this very long report, and we responded to some of those views. Okay, so we had a very systematic way to document your views. So we categorized into four types of comments. The first was sort of knowledge-based comments. You ask a lot of questions about the project. You ask a lot of questions about the process. And we responded and replied right at the spot, and also provided additional information in the handout. The second was design of the project-related comments. Actually, when you saw the project and the presentation by the Lao government, you had immediately questions and recommendations even. And we document those. And then the thirdly, I think it was the very first time where the MRC, in a prior consultation process, put up our review and assessment method to review the project documents. And we sought your feedback on that. I think it was the very first time, and we got a very good comments and where to look at, where to emphasize, where to focus on all of this. So that was the last one, review method, really comments. And some of the key comments I don't have to repeat here, but it has to do with the nature of the PNPCA, the timing of use, you know, what happened to the two projects previously, what lessons learned were taken into account, how you incorporate the stakeholder comments, and everybody thought that the joint action plan was a good idea. And we also heard a lot of comments on each of the technical aspects of the presentation. Right, so this is basically on the methodology, from hydrology, sediment, fish, environment, social condition, safety, and navigation. And just to show you, we made these three columns matrix. The comments was on the first column, and the respondent at the forum was the second column, and how we have addressed these comments in the technical review report is in the third column. So this will be on the website, and we have printed some copies here for you to see. So we appreciate very much that you took the time to fill in the survey at the last forum, which gave us a lot of feedback. So I only show the positive ones. But generally, I think it was appreciation that the forum was open and
transparent and participatory, and that everybody has time to add their viewpoints, and that the comments were taken into account and recorded. We also heard that there were 5 issues that are top on everybody's mind, and we focus our technical review on those. For example, fish sediment, water flow, hydrology, coordination among the dams in the cascade. So, here we are. After a few months, we have done a fair bit, and I think Dr. Hatta will tell you what we have done. But the purpose of today's forum is that we will present you now the preliminary findings of our review. So this is still preliminary, it's still under consultation, but it will be very important to seek your thoughts on these findings as well. Did we do it correctly? Did you agree with us? Where did we not look, etc. And to solicit further recommendation from you in terms of finalizing this report. So the report is very thick and very technical. What we did for the stakeholder is we summarized it and put on our website. So if you have a chance to read that, I think you have a very good idea of what we're talking about in terms of the assessment. And we also want to share with you at the end of the day where we go next. Future forums, future information sharing, future reporting. Okay, I think that's it. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for that. The floor is open for about 2 or 3 questions for clarifications and for further explanation. Dr. Anurag is still here with me. Anybody has any questions to ask Dr. Anurag about what has been done from the first forum to now?
One question to mention in the stakeholder, and then why you are not include the committee representative, because the Mekong River is they are also living on the Mekong River. And the second question for the first PMPCA, I think that compared to downtown, it is a very poor quality. Why? Because if we observe the downtown, they also inviting the Mekong committee representative and then the lowland and also the Malaysia to participate. But for the Back Bay, it's no committee representative because I don't know because of the results of the budget or of the what is behind this. This is a question and then a clarification. So we want to see the PMPCA, it is a good platform, and then why consultation with the community, representative community, the people who depend on the river is very, 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 I think that very useful for us to get their perspective, listen their concern, and bring all necessary concern to be to take in the planning or respond with them. So.
Managed by the National Mekong Committees, and they have several national consultations public forum plan at a national level. So I think you're from Cambodia, right? So I think we can have maybe more discussion, or we can also get more information from the Cambodia National Mekong Committee, what kind of consultation and invitation was at the national level. But at the regional level, which is managed by us, it's an open invitation. So it's an open invitation. Everybody can participate. And we send invitation to as many stakeholders that we know as possible. But the focus has to be on the regional level of organizations, because we thought that this is an additional added value on top of the national processes. So that's my zero proposal.
I would like to inform you that actually to provide more detail on this. As we have this national consultation in Vietnam in Cần Thơ on 12 May, so in 2 days from now. So that's one information I think that confirms that we do listen, I mean the whole process does listen to the communities. Then, if I'm not mistaken, Thailand already conducted 2 national consultations and they plan to conduct the third one. three already. Okay, here we have Thailand here. So this is next. I think this is also something we didn't say. This is a regional one, but there are many national presentations.
Thank you very much, Dr. Anurag and Dr. Fan. I think we should move on to the next presentation by Director Hada from the Planning Division of the Mekong River Secretariat.
So my presentation is about what we have done and what we plan to do to complete our 6-month time of consultation, the official, with the term official consultation process. I think Dr. Anurag asked those only participated in the last forum, but I would like to know those who did not attend the last forum in Rokrabang, because I have something I'm going to tell you guys. Please raise your hand. Those did not. Okay, a quite number, so it's good because my first two slides basically indicate to you. So what is PNDCA and what is my consultation process? Basically, the procedure PNDCA derived built upon article number 5 is about reasonable and equitable utilization of the Mekong River system. And this is the procedure. We have three four distinct forms of interstate communication. The first one we call notification, and the notification is the use of the dry tributary water and wet season use intervention. So this is go to the notification. But prior consultation is dry season use in mainstream and interbasin use in bad season. It has to go to that category. And the last one, the most stringent one, is specific agreement between interbasin use in dry seasons. So these are the three forms between the procedures. For the case of pathways, it's a prior consultation. Why? Because it represents a year-round use of the Mekong water in the mainstream. And in order to implement the procedure clearly refer to this principle. I mean, this is the principle that our procedure has to adhere to, starting from the subject quality, to integrity, down to good faith and transparency in the implementation. So, again, PNDCA is not a veto right or nor a right to generally use without taking the legitimate interest of the notified country into consideration. So this is we have to remember. So what does it imply? It implies that PNDCA not a yes and no decision process. So what it mean? So it rather, if you refer to the procedure article, so if you refer to article 5.4.3 of the procedure, the NPCA procedure, it clearly mentioned by the end of the 6-month prior consultation process, the joint committee aimed at unanimous decision on the conditions. The condition here, what the Secretary of Defense do, they are translated into what we call a statement. Within the statement, we call upon the notified country to include this one, a set of measures in order to provide the opportunity to all the stakeholders to engage in the development, the project development. So this is what we plan to do. When we talk about set of procedures, later on, because this morning Dr. Alan mentioned about joint action plan, and the secretary, I think, also shared during the previous forum the idea of joint action plan.